How did Christ end up as a religion? How do our present life and political arena, our wars, and certain groups fit in with yesterday's history, which has shaped today's world? In its first stage, Christianity begins not as a religion. It begins rather as a movement of people around a single charismatic teacher or preacher. And it's hard to know what noun to use exactly. I would call him a holy man who attracted a crowd of disciples who followed him and his various wanderings as he did his healings and his teachings. But this holy man winds up in Jerusalem and winds up executed by the authorities, probably as a troublemaker, somebody who's best off dead rather than alive, because alive, who knows what may happen. He's a threat to the social order and best off executed. Christianity started about 2,000 years ago in Judea, present day Israel, with Jesus Christ and his faithful group of disciples. Judea was a cross-culture mix of bustling cities and farms. The emperor of Rome was the ruler. The Jews at the time hated Roman rule. It was but another reminder of the historical oppression they faced as people. The polytheistic culture belief of Rome were also pagan and intrusive to Jewish life. Some Jews saw that their only hope was to conform to this change. Others became religious zealots who formed pockets of guerrilla resistance against Rome. Still, others withdrew themselves into the Judean wilderness to study the Jewish law and wait for the eventual coming of their promised Messiah, their Savior. With this culture and religious backdrop, the ministry of Jesus began. Jesus was a Jew. He observed the Jewish faith and was well acquainted with Jewish law. In the early 30s, Jesus traveled from village to village, teaching in the synagogues and healing those who were suffering. But prior to that, Jesus studied under the Vedic Brahmanas and priests before returning to his homeland to preach, which some evidence indicates. Then I'm sure it would come as a shock to most Christians that Jesus was initiated at the Vedic wisdom of India. Thus, he naturally based much of his own teachings on the Vedic knowledge, as anyone who is familiar with Eastern philosophy can see. This would also explain why there are so many similarities between early Christianity and the Dharmic wisdom, much of which seems to have been lost from the Christian fold through the ages. It is obvious that Christianity is but a modified form of Satana Dharma, yet since Jesus spoke in parables on many occasions, the connection with Vedic knowledge and the deeper meaning of his teachings are not always made clear. In fact, there have been numerous diversions and misunderstandings made because of this, as shown by the hundreds of sects that have developed within the Christian community. So essentially, this would also mean that you cannot comprehend the deepest aspect of Jesus' teachings without understanding Vedic scripture or the philosophy of the Satana Dharma, since those are really the roots of Christianity and the basis of the teaching of Jesus. Jesus' teaching was revolutionary. He challenged the established religious authority to repent from their self-righteousness and hypocrisy and realize that the kingdom of God is rooted in service and love. Jesus' teaching stirred the hearts of people and created instability, something the Jewish religious authorities feared. Soon, a faithful group of men began to follow Jesus and called him teacher. Jesus came to awaken our abilities, to show us the way, but because he challenged the old ways, he was killed and his message destroyed, made into a religion, something he fought long and hard to get rid of. There is a great mystery in how this all happened, how such an extraordinary reversal that began with Jesus, who was executed by the Romans as a public criminal, as a threat to the social order, and somehow we wind up 3 centuries later with Jesus being hailed as a god, as part of the one true God who is the God of the new Christian Roman Empire. There is a remarkable progress, a remarkable development in the course of 3 centuries. It's hard to understand exactly how it happened or why it happened, but it is important to realize that we have a progression and a set of developments, and that Christianity by the 4th century is not the same as the Christianity that we see in the 1st or even the 2nd. One of the most surprising Christian heroes in the entire tradition is Constantine, What happened is that Constantine had a vision. Luckily for the church, there is a bishop nearby to interpret what the visions mean. Constantine ends not converting technically to Christianity, but becoming a patron of one of the particular branch of the church. One of the first things Constantine does as emperor is start persecuting other Christians. The Gnostic Christians are targeted, and other dualistic Christians, Christians who don't have the Old Testament as part of their canon, are targeted. The list of enemies goes on and on. We can only imagine the political intervention and misinformation provided to include the manipulation of Jesus' words, the martyr, and guilt-driven practice we see today. Let us bring back the Christ consciousness, the true spiritual teachings of Christ, that Jesus came here on earth to teach us and help awaken us. Namaste.